What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about using MDT with Windows Autopilot for existing devices. So let's get right into it. Now, this video is all about this article that I found within deploymentresearch.com. The first thing that we need to do is get into the GitHub and retrieve all this information within the MDT folder. Once we do that, there's another article that I already did a video on, and it's all about downloading the deployment profile. So hopefully you guys check that out, because you definitely need to download your deployment profile within your Azure or Intune. So I already downloaded the MDT stuff, and I already have the download Intune deployment profile on the desktop. So I'm gonna really do this real quick with you guys. Within the MDT folder, you have three folders. You have the scripts, templates, and unattend. Within the scripts, you have a PowerShell called clean up for autopilot. Within templates, you have an XML file, and the unattend, you have an XML file that we need to actually copy and paste into your deployment share, which I'm going to show you guys. And last but not least, we have the PowerShell script. Now, what I'm going to do is click on the start menu. I'm going to type in ISE. I'm going to right click on the Windows PowerShell ISE, and I'm going to run it as an administrator. Once you do that, on the toolbar, I'm going to click on the folder to open a file, and I'm going to go into the desktop, and I'm going to locate that download into deployment profile, and I'm going to open it up. Now, this PowerShell script, I already did a video with you guys detailing how to run it and what you need to do and what happens. So I'm just going to run it, and it's actually going to drop the JSON file within the temp folder. There it goes. We need to take this autopilot configuration file and we need to move it. Now, where are we going to move it? We need to locate your deployment share, and inside the root of your deployment share folder, we're going to create another folder. We're going to call it autopilot. And within this autopilot folder, we're going to actually copy that JSON file in there. Now, next thing that we need to do is actually get into the scripts folder that we downloaded within the GitHub, and we need to make a copy of the cleanup for autopilot PowerShell script. And within your deployment share folder, locate scripts, open that up, and then copy that PowerShell script inside that folder. Now, within the templates folder that we downloaded within the GitHub, you got the XML file. We need to make a copy of that. Head over to your deployment share, locate the templates folder, open that up, and then copy that in there, okay? Now, we're going to open up your deployment workbench, and within here, we're going to go into task sequences. We're going to right-click on task sequences, and we're going to select new task sequence. You're going to get the wizard and enter the following. This is up to you. You don't really need to enter what I'm entering, so it all depends on your environment. I'm going to enter the following task sequence ID, and I'm going to give it the following task sequence name, right? Pretty self-explanatory. We're going to click next here. On the drop-down menu, once you click on the drop-down menu, we're going to see our new task sequence, Windows Autopilot for existing devices. Now, click next here. I'm going to select Windows 11, and I am going to select my flavor. That is what I picked. Click next here. For the product key, I left it as the default. I click next. For the OS settings, I provided the following information. I clicked next. I gave it a local admin password and I confirmed it, and I clicked next. A nice little summary, click next, and it is done and you're finished. And there goes our new autopilot task sequence. Now, if you double click on it, within the task sequence, you're going to see the copy cleanup for autopilot PowerShell, and also copy autopilot JSON file for it to work during the deployment. Now, one last thing that we need to do is we actually have to take that unintend.xml file and we need to move it over to our new task sequence. So go inside your unintend folder, make a copy of that, head over to your deployment share, go inside control and locate your task sequence. Now, I called my task sequence, the ID was actually autopilot 01. So I went inside the autopilot 01 folder, which is there. I'm going to double click on that and I'm going to paste that unintend.xml file. You're going to get this because I'm replacing the existing one. So say replace the file in the destination, head back inside your deployment workbench, right click on the MDT deployment share, update deployment share, Click next here, click next, and you are done. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video. Do not go anywhere. There is going to be a speed video of me creating a virtual machine, pixie booting into my MDT server, picking that task sequence, and then deploying an operating system and also utilizing the autopilot feature. Now, I do cut it short because I did not want my virtual machine to be part of my Intune, but this particular setup does work with no problems. Hopefully you guys enjoy, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.